Oh, well, guys, what we'll do today? We'll discuss our constitution, okay, from the political science, that is the chapter one, okay, our constitution. Okay, in this particular chapter, what we're going to learn. The Constituent Assembly of Constitution, okay, and the Constitution Drafting Committee. Okay, there was one committee, okay, who on whom the drafting committee, the writing responsibility was there. About that we'll discuss, and framing of Constitution. Okay, how this drafting committee has framed the Indian Constitution, that we'll learn in this particular chapter. And the preamble to the Constitution, that is the introduction to the Constitution, that is very short and very informative they have written. Okay, about that we will try to learn. And silent features of the Constitution they have added in this particular chapter, and they have added about the fundamental rights to the every citizen of India, the fundamental duties, okay, which every citizen need to obey, and DPSP, Directive Principles of State Policy. Okay, all these things we will going to learn in this particular chapter one, our constitution. Particularly in today's class, what you're going to learn about the Constituent Assembly and the drafting committee and preamble of the constitution and the silent features of the Indian Constitution we will going to learn. Okay, in introduction part they talked about, okay, when India got freedom from the British in 1947, India had many problems, okay, soon after their independence. So one of the major problem was rehabilitating the refugees who are coming from the Pakistan. Okay, so the Indian Muslims, they were moving to Pakistan, and Pakistan Hindus, Muslims, they were migrating to the India and settling those refugees. Okay, ಆ ದೇಶಲಿಂತ ಪಾಕಿಸ್ತಾನಲಿಂತ ಹೊರಗಡೆ ಹಾಕಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಭಾರತಕ್ಕೆ ಬಂದವರನ್ನ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಸ್ಪೇಸ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಟ್ಟದ್ದು. ದೇರ್ ವರ್ ಮೆನಿ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಅಂಡ್ ಮರ್ಜರ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರಿನ್ಸ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಒನ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಗಾಟ್ ದ ಫ್ರೀಡಮ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷ್, ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದಾಟ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಅವರ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ವಾಸ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಮೆನಿ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಬಿಗ್ ಪ್ರಿನ್ಸ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಸ್. Okay, so uniting the princely states and making one nation, it was a big challenge to the Sardar Vallabhai Patel. Okay, so he has took the initiation of this uniting India under one head, and he successfully succeeded in that particular task. Okay, so there were, okay, of 565 self-governing states at that time. Okay, after independence, India got independence. So the Iron Man of India, Sardar Vallabhai Patel, took a lot of effort to uniting these 565 self-governing princely states and adding them into one nation. Okay. So Sardar Vallabhai Patel, at that time he worked as the first home minister to the Indian government, and he was the deputy prime minister to the Jawaharlal Nehru. Okay, so again, Sardar Patel successfully achieved the merger and the princely states, merger of the princely states and provinces with the Union of India, and even challenge of the framing of constitution in order to enable us to govern the country was also fulfilled. Okay, so we have united successfully. We have united the India under one nation. After that, we need one particular law book, okay, which tells the rules and regulations how the country need to move. Okay, there should be one route map, right? So the framing of route map was also one of the challenge in front of our political leaders at that time. So now, okay, we will learn about the constitution, samvidhana. Okay, so the constitution framing committee, drafting committee, all that thing they have made, and after a few days successfully the efforts of Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar and many more persons, okay, that has resulted in the Indian Constitution. So in our Indian Constitution, they have mentioned about fundamental rights, fundamental duties, directive principles of state policy, many things. Okay, we will going to learn in this particular chapter. Okay, first what we'll do, we will try to learn about preamble to the Constitution. So the preamble, okay, it's a preamble, that is a introduction part. Okay, how they have introduced whole Constitution in a particular one frame, that is under the preamble. Okay, so the Indian Constitution has combined in itself the best features of different constitutions of the world and has its own preamble. The preamble contains the fundamental policies, ideals of the Constitution. It is the sum of the structure, values, principles, and goals of the Constitution. The preamble of Constitution is based on the aspirations and ideals of the people of India. The preamble is a part of the objective resolution put forward by our first Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru on December 13, 1946. And approved by the Constituent Assembly on January 22, 1947. This particular resolution upholds the natures of India's sovereign, democratic, republic nature, social, economical, and political justice for all the people is upheld. So this is the preamble to the Indian Constitution. Okay. So the preamble to our Constitution is very meaningful. It describes our political system and it is a key to understand our Constitution. Okay, so once you read only this introduction part of a preamble of Indian Constitution, you will come to know what our whole Constitution talks about. Okay, it has been described as the jewel of the Constitution. The preamble of Indian Constitution is described as jewel of Constitution, and K.K. Munshi has referred to it as the political horoscope. K.K. Munshi said in this preamble of the Constitution is political horoscope, okay, where it will talk about everything about how the Indian future will be. Okay, so this preamble of India, it starts with we the citizen of India. Okay, we the Indian citizens. So the preamble of Constitution begins with the we the people of India, because our Indian Constitution is written by our own people, that we have to remember. They have strived to fulfill the dreams of Indians in the Indian Constitution. Okay, so that's why in the preamble, in the beginning sentences, they have added the words like we the Indian citizens. Okay, then in the preamble they have added sovereign. Okay, they mentioned India as the sovereign nation. India is a sovereign country and not under the control of any other country in the world. So our nation, okay, in our Constitution itself, we said India is a sovereign country where we are independent. Okay, we as a India, we are the independent nation and Indians are independent. Okay, we are not ruled by any other country. Okay, we are having every power to take the decisions of our own foreign policies, non-alignment policy. We are working on the five-year plans. Okay, so we are having full authority over the internal and external autonomy of our particular India. Okay, so that has been mentioned in the our preamble itself, in the beginning, the introduction part itself. Then after sovereign, our India preamble, it talks about the socialist. Okay, where our Indian Constitution, it creates the social equality and promote the welfare of all the people who lives in our country. Okay, so it talks about the directive principles of state policy. Okay, where through the 42nd amendment, okay, which they have done in 1976, yeah, through that they have added the directive principles of state policy. Through this amendment, land reforms and other progressive economic reforms were also introduced. And next word which we have added in our preamble is secular. Okay, the word secular has been incorporated in the constitution through 42nd amendment in 1976. According to this secular word, where although our India has many religion, we are having Hindus, Muslims, Christs, many religions, but finally what we say, we are one and we are one nation. So India is a secular country. We don't have any national religion to our India, although the Hinduism is the major religion in India. We have not made Hinduism as the national religion, that we have to remember. India doesn't have any national religions. India is a secular country, we talk. Where if you take the examples of other countries, other neighboring countries, Pakistan and Afghanistan and Bangladesh, they are having their national religions. Pakistan, it has made Islam as the national religion, where Pakistan is not a secular country. So here our India, we talk about equality and we give the respect to all the religions. We measure them in the equal status. So that's why in the Indian constitution's preamble itself, we have added the word like secular. All religions have equal status in our particular country called India. Next, in our preamble itself, we mentioned about democratic republic. So securing the happiness of everyone is the responsibility of the government in our country. So problems are solved through the discussions. Elections are held every 5 years in our country. Through universal adult franchises, every citizen who crosses their 18 years of age, they are eligible to vote. The fact that our head of the state, that is the president of our country, is elected for a period of 5 years, and that proves that our country is republic. So this is about the preamble of our Indian constitution. Next, we'll move towards the silent features of our constitution. First feature, lakshanagalu. Bharata samvidhanada lakshanagalu. First feature is Indian constitution is written and lengthy constitution. Written and lengthy constitution. Our Indian constitution, it is in the written form. The drafting committee, they have written this Indian constitution, and the powers and functions of the organs, governments like legislature, executive, judiciary have been delineated in the constitution. We have written about fundamental rights, fundamental duties, DPSP, that is directive principles of state policy, etc. That is in written form, we can say, in our constitution. And originally, our constitution, it was consisted of 22 chapters, 8 schedules, and 395 articles. Later, many amendments have been done to the Indian constitution, and as of now, we are having 25 chapters, 12 schedules, and 465 articles, so which makes lengthiest constitution in the world. So that is one of the feature of our Indian constitution. Indian constitution is written and lengthy constitution. Then our Indian constitution is partially flexible and partially rigid constitution. When you want to make the changes in our Indian constitution, so it is a bit flexible. You can make changes according to your changing scenario. Again, it talks about the partially rigid. It's not too easy. Like if Prime Minister thoughts he can make the changes, or if President thoughts he can make the changes in a particular constitution, it will not allow easily. There are few rigid rules and regulations one need to follow to make the amendments in the Indian constitution. So that is another feature of our Indian constitution, partially flexible and partially rigid. Then our next feature of Indian constitution is parliamentary form of government. Our constitution provide for a parliamentary form of government. The sovereign power of the nation is vested in the elected parliament. The executive is responsible for the legislature at the center and the state levels. The cabinet shall be in power as long as it enjoys the confidence of the legislature. As soon as it loses the confidence of the legislature, it has to resign. Okay, so parliamentary form of government, that is also one of the form of silent feature of our Indian constitution. Then republican system is also one of the feature of our Indian constitution. The constitution has declared India as a republic. The head of the country is indirectly elected by the citizens. In India, the president is the constitutional head of the state and he is also elected. Okay, so we are having a republican system where people are selecting their leaders. Okay, our president of India and prime ministers of India, they are elected from the people directly or indirectly. Again, one of the silent feature of Indian constitution is fundamental rights. Okay, the rights that constitution has given to the all the people, okay, all the peoples of India, no law of any government, central government or state or any organization can deny these fundamental rights from the every citizen of India. If the fundamental rights are taken away or if the fundamental rights are in the endangered, the citizen can directly appeal to the High Court or Supreme Court. These rights are listed in the third part of the Constitution. So, High Courts and Supreme Courts will look after towards these fundamental rights if the government is not taking care of that one. Like right to education, right to equality, freedom to religion. There are many fundamental rights are there. Okay, we will discuss that in a later part. Then one of the silent feature of Indian constitution is fundamental duties. Okay, the duties are our responsibilities of every citizen which we need to do towards our country. Okay, there are 11 fundamental duties have been delineated in a part of the fourth chapter under the clause 51A of our constitution. Through 86th amendment to the constitution in 2002, it has been made a duty of our parents to provide compulsory education to their children aged between 6 to 14 years. Okay, so this is the 11th duty mentioned in the constitution. So as of now, we are having 11 fundamental duties which we need to do. Then our another feature of our Indian constitution is it talks about DPSP, directive principles of state policy. Directive principles of state policy have been incorporated in the fourth schedule of our constitution. These principles have been adopted from the Irish constitution. Okay, Ireland, it is in the European continent. From that country, okay, from Ireland's constitution, we have took this DPSP, directive principles of state policy. They are the basic principles required for the administration of the country. At the government cannot be questioned by a court of justice if it does not implement them. When the government frames new laws, it should pay attention to these directive principles of state policy. Again, independent and centralized judiciary system. Okay, our judiciary system is independent and centralized. Nyayanga vyavastha en helthivi, the courts have the authority to give bold judgments in order to protect the rights of the people. Neither the legislature nor the executive has the right to interfere with the working of the judiciary. The Supreme Court is the highest court in the land. Okay, highest court in our Indian land is Supreme Court of India, which is in Delhi, and all high courts and subordinate courts function under it. The district courts, taluka courts, session courts, high courts, they work under Supreme Court of India. Supreme Court is the highest court in our India. So independent and centralized judiciary system is also one of the feature of our Indian constitution. And next feature of our Indian constitution is it talks about single citizenship. The Constitution makes provision for the single citizenship in order to curb the narrow-minded provincialism and promote nationalism. The citizens of this country have the same rights irrespective of their place of birth or their existence. Okay, either you born in Tamil Nadu, or you born in Jammu and Kashmir, or you born in Arunachal Pradesh, or if you are born in Gujarat or Odisha part, everybody have the equal rights and all those things. Okay, same rights they are having. Okay, if you born in any corner of India, you are treated as the same citizen in our according to Indian Constitution. Okay, so our Indian Constitution, it talks about single citizenship. Okay, if any foreigner he want to adopt our citizenship, then he has to remove his country's citizenship and he has to take our Indian citizenship. Okay, there are few countries which talks about dual citizenship, but our India, in Indian Constitution itself, we have mentioned about single citizenship. Then another feature of Indian Constitution is it talks about adult franchise, where the youngsters who are the above the age of 18 are having the right to vote. Okay, every citizen who takes born in our India and who is having the age of more than 80, he is having the right of vote. Okay, so it symbolizes the sovereign absolute power of the people. And another feature of our Indian Constitution is it is bicameral. So the central legislature is called the parliament, and the parliament consists of two houses, that is lower house and upper house. Lower house is called the Lok Sabha, and upper house is also called as Rajya Sabha. The lower house leaders are directly elected from the ground level people, the citizen of India. Okay, he votes and sends the ministers to the lower house, and the elected members, okay, they vote and they send people to the Rajya Sabha. So that's why here we can see in the Lok Sabha there is a green carpet. Okay, where they it symbolizes the leaders are from ground level. Okay, who have been directly won from the people of the citizen of India. Okay, common man. Then another feature of our Indian Constitution is it talks about party system. Okay, India, it has many parties in our country, and these parties are the pillars of democracy. Okay, so the party which wins the majority of the votes from the votes in the general election, that becomes the ruling party, and who loses the majority, they becomes the opposition party. So we are having national parties like Bharatiya Janata Party, National Congress, Indian National Congress, Bahujan Samaj Party, National Congress Party, that is the NCP, Communist, okay, All India Trinamool Congress. These are all national parties of our India. And so if you talk about present scenario, Bharatiya Janata Party, it is in ruling, and these Congress and other parties in the opposition. Okay, so Bharatiya Janata Party, with the leadership of Narendra Modi, they got the majority votes, okay, in recent election, and they are in the power like that. Okay, our Indian Constitution, it talks about the multi-party system. Okay, party system. So this is about silent features of Indian Constitution, and what preamble talks, and what is the introduction part of this particular chapter, our Constitution. Next, fundamental rights, fundamental duties, and direct principles of state policy we will discuss in our next class. Till then, take care. Bye bye.